The reason why prophets such as Christ and Muhammad didn't teach this practice of changing your belief systems is because it's really through surrender that you transcend a more limited version of yourself. You can see it in this way. There is no like you that is actually there which has a bunch of belief systems, and then if it changes it, then it's going to feel super happy because now it has all these positive beliefs and all these loving beliefs and all these beliefs that do not limit you. But that's not the reality of how it is. I know that there's a lot of people out there that sell courses and sell all sorts of seminars and books, etc., to teach you on how to change your beliefs, and it can give you short-term results, whereas you get like in this state like, oh my god, I am in charge of my own destiny, I can make good things happen, all the shit that happened in the past was because I wasn't in charge of my destiny, I didn't know how to do this and this and this. So this exhilaration, you can kind of live on that euphoria for a little bit until God or life, universe slaps you in the face and shows you that you're not in charge, you have a destiny, and you're only purpose is actually to surrender to everything that arises, and that is what makes you transcend these limiting let's say the attachments that you have to limitation is what keeps you on a lower vibration. And the lower your vibration, the more limiting thoughts you get to hear, because you're truly like a radio station. The frequency that you're tuned to is what you're going to hear surrounding you. So it's not that there is a you that has 100 negative belief systems, so you change those belief systems and you're finished. If that was so easy, then everyone will walk around like an angel, right? Nobody would ever experience any limitation. If there was truly the result of working on your beliefs, it's not true. It's actually you doing the work through surrender to what is. You completely falling into trust each moment of the day. That is what how God actually purifies you from every attachment that you have. So it's exactly surrendering to these very unpleasant sensations. If you don't do that, and instead jump onto some method to stop your suffering with all costs and trying to do something about it, that's actually what is going to keep you small. And because you do not allow that painful sensation, let's say it's shame or guilt, you do not fully feel it. Instead, you jump to the next book or to the next method to kind of get it done, fix it, and then the next time God again has to, like, you're because of that wound, you again have to attract situations that are very painful, that are very triggering, because that wound hasn't fully healed yet. And it's not a belief, it can be a belief, but it's usually a repressed emotion. It's actually a stagnant energy in the body that is then connected to a belief, but it's not the belief that needs to change. What needs to be fully felt and surrendered to is that shame, is those sensations. And every time you do it, that's how you transcend the more limiting versions of yourself. At least that's how it has happened for me. It was not like in one day that I was super bounded by fear, and the next day I woke up, it was gone. It was a gradual, constant surrender to every unpleasant sensation in my body. Every day, again and again and again. It actually started off with the Kundalini awakening somewhere around that time, before I was already trying to feel things. But, you know, trying to feel things is something else than actually feeling everything. Trying to feel things is still like a method that you use to get rid of suffering. But actually, true surrender is when you're absolutely fine with suffering as being happy. There is no, like, you become so equanimous to it in a way, because you see that that is your doorway to transcendence. So I started to, at some point, treat my pain as a doorway to transcendence. Because I didn't use it as a method to get rid of suffering. It was just in the moment, everything that I would feel as discomfort in my body, I would just feel it. I wouldn't jump onto a method to make the suffering go away. Why? Why? I was just there like, okay, as long as the suffering is here, I'm going to be here with the suffering. And doesn't mean that I cannot move on and do things. Like I would usually have these few minutes that I would absolutely concentrate on the pain in the body. And then I was like, okay, let's do the dishes. So there was not like this overthinking and over obsessing about the stories about the pain and what other people have to do or what I have to do. Like, overthinking is this problem solving thing because you don't want to feel the pain. Life already happens on its own. Already things are going to happen because you have a destiny that is already preset. As long as you're still fighting against that fact, with seminars, with courses, with all these methods, with resistance, you're resisting the very fact that life is already living itself. So you go against God. A lot of you are just avoiding. Your whole life is based on avoidance of painful sensations. Everything you do is to avoid not feeling something else. That's the opposite of surrender. You can read 10,000 of books. It's, as long as you're avoiding these sensations in your body, you're not going to transcend these limiting versions of you. And with limiting versions of you is what I mean. Like, let's say the version of you that is on 70. There's also a version of you that is on 100. There's a version of you that is on 200. And all the way you can go until the top, until full enlightenment, where you are love and light itself. Like, literally nothing. how can I say it? Yeah, you become the love and the light of God. You are love. So these limiting ideas or thoughts, they don't even, like, these fearful thoughts don't even come. They can be there, but it's like they have like zero impact on you. There's like zero painful sensations in the body. There is reactions, like you can cry, you can feel tension in the body if you're like, I don't know, I mean, all sorts of things can happen. Yeah, you can find yourself in the war zone. You can, like, all sorts of things can happen. But I remember when I was interviewed on the airport of Israel, the man said to me, like, why are you so calm? Because he was a bit confused as to why I wasn't like nervous or anything. And they found me actually very strange. So he thought that I would be like this Bambi that was not going to be safe in Jerusalem, and he said, I feel I have to protect you by sending you back to Europe. So I wasn't allowed to go in, but he made a few comments. We had a very long conversation. He made a few comments as to why I, like, as where I got the reflection that, yeah, I'm experiencing reality in a different way than other people. I kind of knew it, but you forget it, and since you cannot just jump into other people's heads, at some point you just get used to it. You get used to not feeling negativity. You get used to not feeling fear. You get used to not really being strategic about the next moment. You're just like, God guides you. God guided me to go there, and I had to pack my bags and go there and state and tell everyone, like, I'm going there. So there was one of my tasks that I had to fulfill. I guess looking back at it was God testing me, like, are you ready to go to a war zone to help people? Like, are you ready to manifest that degree of fearlessness? And I didn't really have a choice. I had a moment where I had to transcend that version of me that said, well, it's a war zone. You're not safe there. You don't know anyone there. What's you gonna do there? But it took, I think it took a little while that I felt like my body mind was kind of ruminating about like, okay, should I do this or not? But then of course the guidance is priority over what the mind says and all these valid reasons, of course. But that's only valid when you're living in the reality of fear. Then you're only also going to manifest things that are on that frequency. So in my life, I've made a different decision. In my life, the world is not as important. In my life, I had a different orientation. For me, had I been shot there, let's say I would be there and something would happen and I would be shot there, I would really accept that because I know that I've done what God guided me to do. But if you're not in that, if you're not, let's say, if you're not guided by God yet, but you have all these confusing thoughts where these fearful thoughts fight with the loving thoughts, I can understand that you cannot trust yourself in that. And you would say, like, I would be crazy to go to a war zone. But yeah, I had to do that to transcend a version of myself that wasn't ready to go to a war zone. So the more you like, the higher your vibration becomes, and that has to do with how much you are willing to trust, how much you're willing to surrender to God's guidance. Another example, I use this example very often. Abraham had to kill his son. Why? He had to transcend that version of him that was afraid to kill his son. Can you imagine? If you have so much trust in God that you're ready to kill your son, sacrifice your son, and then when he was ready to do it, God said, no, you can slaughter an animal. And you have fulfilled your task, so to say. So it's really true. It's not only the prophets that get tested in this way. It's also you. I've now been chatting with a few people that are kind of also going through what I've been through, where they feel like they're being tested and they have certain tasks to fulfill, whereas they have to transcend certain fearful versions of themselves. And usually these tasks are very are things that you have to do that go against your ego, against your beliefs, against what everyone else around you thinks is good to do. Your task is going to be something more like risky, or where you're gonna seem like a fool in front of other people. You have to say something that other people can like think you're crazy or laugh at you, or in front of family you can have things that like, it all comes down to when you're going to integrate your root chakra. You have a lot of beliefs that say, if I say or do this, I will get rejected. If I say or do this, this person's not going to want to be with me. Da, da, da. So to transcend that version of you who feels ungrounded, who's afraid to be rejected by the tribe, so to say. Right now we don't live in tribes, but our inner circles are our tribes. And if you have Instagram, your inner tribe is watching you there. So it's actually an amazing tool to free yourself from a lot of these attachments that you have. At least I use Instagram for that as well, and I think it's a beautiful channel if you only follow the people that are truly contributing something that makes sense to your life. You know, if you just sit there and scroll on brainless advertisements, it's not gonna really uplift you. Well, it's also not the goal to go on Instagram to get uplifted. It's really like connecting with the people that you feel their message can contribute to you, drawing closer to God, drawing nearer to God. And that is transcending the limiting version of you that are built on falsehood, on limitation, on fear. And what holds you back is that sensation that you do not dare to feel because it hurts. And that's why you don't want to do what God wants you to do. That's why you don't dare doing things that God guides you to do. So you stay in your safe, limited space because that feels familiar, that feels safe, etc. So, yeah, God can give you very unusual challenges. If you set the intention that you want to draw near to God, near to truth, that you want to embody the true version of who it is that you came here to be, and then you will truly feel good about yourself. You will feel good about what it is that you do, because you'll be proud that you're not buying into fear. You're not buying into fear. So, yeah, I would say, instead of focusing on belief systems, I think it can become really a way of bypassing your pain. I would say focus on feeling the sensations during the day. There's many moments during the day where a thought comes up and it's not comfortable. You have to be in your belly there to feel it. Resolving the story will never end. Like, you will never resolve the stories. You will never resolve what the mind says. Like, the stories can go on endlessly. The only way how to transcend the vibration that you're still susceptible to hearing these negative stories, say it's like these satanic energies, basically. That's why it's like enlightenment is heaven and pre-enlightenment is hell. Why? Because you're still attuned to these lower frequencies. Yeah? So, when you get a thought that is not comfortable, immediately go to your belly and feel. And that's the fastest way to come to truth. Is to just continuously feel. And ignore the mind, actually, basically. Because when you transcend that limited, lower vibration part version of yourself, you'll see the stories start to change. Because you will not have that repressed emotion anymore. You will not have that stagnant energy anymore in the body that attracts these stories, that attracts people with drama, that attracts people with evil intentions, that attract people that are themselves struggling. You see? People are truly a mirror of who it is that you are. People behave in a certain way that mimics something that is also hidden within you, that's repressed within you. That's what I noticed. That's why when you reach full enlightenment, you'll notice people start to behave differently. Your parents start to talk differently. Doesn't mean you don't get challenges. But you will clearly, I don't know how to describe this to you guys, you will clearly see a very big shift in how reality turns its face to you. And then you will realize, oh my God, this is fucking true. It was all me. Doesn't mean you have to just accept everyone because it's all you. No, that can be also a bypassing strategy. That's also not something that I do. It's this new age love. Where it's like, oh, you just show compassion and tolerance to everyone and then you have a bunch of demons that sit next to you. No. If you are very intuitive and you see someone fucking it up for a couple times, or you see someone doesn't make progress in their lives and they're still with you, no. They have to go, you have to stop their access to you. That is love. That's love for you. You don't love yourself if you gather all these people that are on a very low frequencies, and they're gonna affect you, influence you, hurt you in various ways that you're not even would be expecting to happen to you, because you think, oh, I'm showing love. No, you're not loving yourself. So, yeah, I would say, don't focus too much on limiting beliefs, because those change based on the vibration that you are. And the fastest way to transcend the lower frequencies is to fully surrender to the sensation that they bring up in you. That's actually the hook that keeps you hooked to these lower frequencies. is this stagnant energy. They love that. They love this stagnation, this resistance. It's basically a tool of Satan to stay near, is your resistance. Your resistance. Your resistance. You don't want to feel pain. You don't want to feel pain. Then that's basically where this life is for. God is testing you through Satan. If you're worthy to become someone who is fully trusting and fully surrendering to God. And then you get rewarded with the kingdom of heaven. So you actually have to earn it through surrender. But not through you trying to work yourself up into the kingdom of heaven. Anticipating on what's going on to happen. That's you resisting. At some point you have to lose all your orientation. You don't know what is going to happen. And you will notice your brain can work the best way in that space. You will notice that that's how you were destined to function. Where you're not attached to anything. You will see like you have all this freedom to do as God wants you to do. And you'll not feel as much doubt anymore. Doubt is in places where you're still avoiding pain. That's why you get to please people and doubt your decisions, fear this, fear that. It's like the more you resist, the lower your vibration, the more fears you get to hear. Like your radio station will be attuned to more fear, like, and that's stress. Like stress is like this lower frequency that you kind of lock in because of resistance. Because you have an attachment to feeling good. That's usually where it comes down to. I have a whole Zoom meeting with my patrons devoted to why trying to feel good is the root of all evil. Because that is where resistance is born. That is where all these addictions are about. It's like, oh, I don't feel good. Let me smoke. Let me drink. Let me do this. Let me do that. Like it's constantly seeking for relief. Seeking for good feeling. So wanting to feel good is the worst that you can actually anticipate on. I know there's a lot of spiritual bullshit on there. That very sneaky, these satanic energies have tricked people into thinking that if you feel good, that means that you are on alignment with God. Know how sneaky that is? That whole thought pattern that the better you feel, the more aligned you are with God. In one way, it's true. That's why a lot of people fall for it. Enlightenment does feel good. But you don't come there by trying to feel good. Actually, people who wake up, if you look at the year prior self-realization, is actually full on shit. It's full on months of dark night, months of like losing people around you because you cannot relate to these old personalities anymore. Like it's if attaining kingdom of heaven is through feeling good, then I would be feeling amazing that whole year prior self-realization, and then it would happen, and then I would be like, oh my god, I did it. No, I felt like oh, there were moments that I've never felt more horrible in my whole life than 2 months, let's say in the last 3 months prior self-realization. The actual last month was equanimity, where I was like, I didn't care. I wasn't really happy, but I was also not depressed. But then the 2 months prior, that month of equanimity, I was wrecked. Like I would wake up with severe anxiety. I would not be able to work. I would just like struggle to get myself ready for the day. And then there was just severe anxiety that I've never ever in my life experienced. Not when I would divorce, not when I would break up, nothing compared to that severe dread and anxiety that I experienced during dark night. Have I ever come close to that in my life? So it's a lie what they've told you in spirituality, that you have to feel good, then you reach God. No, that's how you don't reach God. That's how you get addicted to pleasure and feeling good. No, you are in alignment with God when you're fully in surrender to what is. Don't believe these spiritual bullshit. It's usually these channeled entities that are here streamed into our world through egoic people. They are not even realized or enlightened, so they don't know what they talk about. They just want to feel special. They just want to make a name for themselves by channeling these entities. And many dumb people fall for it. These new age dumb people fall for it. Truly, 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 people with open eyes, they don't fall for these tricks. They don't fall for it. Because it's also contradictory to what Prophet Muhammad and Jesus said. So how can it be true? They always said, surrender, surrender, surrender. So I was happy that I realized that at some point when I come across non-duality. I was like, yeah, I need to surrender. I need to surrender to every pain that I feel. And that's going to be me fully free from resistance. And being fully free from resistance is self-realization. So it's that easy, actually. It's truly way easier than you think it is. You don't have to work towards feeling good. What a liberation. You don't have to feel good. You don't have to resolve anything. All you have to do is just to fully feel the sensations and not resist any second of the day. And then everything flows out of that. Everything happens for you out of that. The self-realization is served you on the golden plate if you just not resist. And in the beginning, you have to train your body. And first, you have to train your body not to resist, because it's like a nervous system response that we got so used to that we don't even notice that we're doing it. And you have to train yourself to reside in your belly. It's also going to take your attention away from your constantly overthinking in your mind. You have to be in your belly. You truly have to be aware those painful contractions are. And you have thousands during the day. Thousands. I remember I couldn't really work as much anymore because I was focusing on this in my life. I was like, I want to feel every sensation in my body, everything. And that I made that my purpose, and that's what I did in the half year prior liberation. And then more and more I could track those sneaky resistances, those sneaky bypasses, those sneaky ways that I still wanted to be seen in certain ways, blah blah blah. But all of that, I didn't try to fix that. I didn't try to become a better person anymore. I didn't try to have all these good qualities anymore. Like, there was like truly surrender. There was no methods. There was no... I remember there was very recently, prior self-realization, I was calling with someone. And I was saying all these things. And I knew, like, I was already like playing the teacher there. And it was like still like something in me that wanted, I guess, to be seen as smart or wise. And there was no thought that said like, oh, I need to change that. I need to stop talking. And it was just like, yeah, that's just what's happening. That's just what's happening. So that I became unconditional acceptance, unconditional love, because I stopped trying to change myself. But I was aware of all these things. I was fully aware. So because as long as you're in the role of the one who constantly tries to change everything about yourself, you're not in embodying you as awareness. You're in the doing part. But that is just already happening on its own. You're not the doer. So it's better to back off and just see how everything is played out in front of you. How the character already wakes up, puts on underwear, goes and brushes teeth. Like all these automatic things. You think you're doing it, but it's all just happening. Try not to do anything. It's hard. Because life is already happening. Try to plan to do something the next day at this particular time. If it happens on its own, it happens. If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. So truly seeing that there is no personal free will also liberate you from constantly resisting what is happening. You have to understand what is happening is what is happening. So fuck it. You feel bad? So what? Feel that. That's the golden moment, actually. You feel it. you don't have to get rid of all these egoic, you know, these egoic games that your mind plays with other people, with yourself, is because you're on a frequency, on a vibration that is attuned to fear. So there is always a strategy to keep yourself safe. No amount of self-help can get you out of that because it's a vibration. So you cannot create heaven in hell. How? How are you going to create heaven in hell? But that is what a lot of people are trying to do with self-help. New age, da-da-da. All that bullshit. They try to create heaven and hell. Can't you not see how stupid that is? That's stupid. It's the stupidest thing you can do. The easiest way out of hell is to fully surrendering and be like, yeah, whatever, I have all these games that my ego plays, so what? Just watch, and then see that the watching is already happening on its own, that you're not even in charge of whether you're watching or not watching. That's one of the last things, one of the last traps of the ego. It's like, stay aware, and then it's like, oh, but the thought that says I have to stay aware arises spontaneously. It's not that I'm commanding that thought to arise, it's just arising, and I get aware of it after it has arisen. So I'm not even in charge of my thoughts. So why bother? And then you will see that even being aware doesn't matter. But already at that time, I was already so aware that even if I stopped trying to be aware, I was already aware. And that was the last day I'm actually in front of the house where it actually happened. It was my previous home where I used to live. In that living room over there, I was dancing. It was evening. And then the veil of separation that was like in front of my eyes fell. It was like some like a feather or something that was like, and then it was done. But well, of course there's also processes of your character getting used to things, so it's not like it's done. It's like there is things that happen afterwards, but that was the moment that the experience of separation stopped. Yeah, experience of separation stopped over there. I didn't become a perfect person because of that. Truly, actually, nothing on the level of the character truly changed, except for, yeah, resistance was not really possible. So therefore, you don't suffer. But you can still have challenges, and you can still be attuned to fear in a way. But it's a difference. It's different. I will make another video probably on that, because otherwise this one I think is going to get too long. And yeah, it's not raining as much anymore, so I guess I can start walking. So yeah, I hope this was helpful and that this can provide some new insights. And maybe it's better to say to break down some old insights that you thought were true but are actually not. And if you truly want to free yourself from suffering, you should only be listening to people who are enlightened. People who are not enlightened, these egoic people about self-help and all these tricks and methods on YouTube, skip them. They don't know it. They're still in hell. But some people are so good at pretending that everything is good because they get money out of it. There's a lot of these spiritual people with law of attraction, and you are in charge of your life if you just change your beliefs. They are making money. It's their business to portray an image of themselves that they all have it together because they have changed their beliefs. So it's their business to show you as if their life is perfect and they're rich and there's this and there's that. But they're only rich because they sell you that lie. They are liars. That's why Prophet Muhammad and Jesus never taught people to focus on attracting stuff. He said, God will give you whatever it is that you need when you need it. You don't have to force things. And absolutely not fall into the trap of thinking that getting things by changing your beliefs is going to make you happy. It's not. Truly, it's not. The only thing that is going to make you happy when you enter the kingdom of heaven, where you are loved all the time, every time, without, no matter your circumstances, no matter what happens, and when you're clean as a leaf. You can argue with someone and 1 minute later it's like clean. Maybe not even 1 minute, maybe 10 seconds later it's like gone. What is said is said. What is felt is felt. What is done and it's done. You cannot drag it along because you're fully, fully new every second of the day. You're birthing, as you would say, like if you meditate truly deeply, it can happen that at some point you catch that reality is not like a film. It's like, it's opening and closing. Reality is not a constant movie. It's flickering, it's on and off, on and off, on and off, on and off. And then your mind has these perceptions that make it into one clean movie, but it's not. And that's, if you can get to catch that at some point, you'll see. Don't make this a goal. I didn't share it for you to create a new goal for yourself. Like, oh, I need to, like, if you see it, it's not gonna change your life. But it can help you realize that you don't have to work so hard, actually. Life already happens on its own. You don't have to try to achieve all sorts of things. It's easier to achieve when you are free from these satanic influences. It's way easier to get things done, to deal with people, to deal with life situations. Very easy. When you're attuned to love, you can only do what is that you're destined to do. So make this your priority and make the way to get there true, true, true surrender. And if you get challenges on the way, you can join my Patreon. You can ask your questions there. You can watch. But you know, some of you, I don't know, guys, when I was seeking enlightenment, I was on the front row with asking questions. I visited the satsang twice and I watched all the satsangs of this Advaita teacher in Holland on YouTube. And then twice I was there. Like, it was like twice in Arnhem, I guess it was. So I was on the front row. I was asking like 4, 5, 6 questions every meeting. I wasn't there like, oh, sleeping, falling asleep, or just there to listen to other people's stories. No, you should actually be actively trying to figure out where you're still avoiding, where you're still bypassing, where you're still trying to feel good, where you're still resisting life, where you're still thinking you're on a way to get happy through resistance. Not gonna happen. Have to resolve all these blind spots. When you resolve all these blind spots, you'll see your ego will give up because it cannot it cannot attach to anything anymore. So it's like, no, there's just what's happening. And radical non-duality truly helped me for seeing it as well, because it stripped away the last remnants of hope that what is could be different than it is. So yeah, and then a profound love can open up to every moment as it is, how ugly or painful it can arise. It's the beauty of life, because it teaches you something. It helps you transcend a part of you that is afraid, a part of you that is still living in limitation. So all is perfect. Everything that arises is perfect. And yeah, I hope one day many, 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 many people get to feel that, get to realize that, not only feel that, get to realize that in their own reality, because it's going to be more joyful for people like me to be engaging and to be working on a shared mission together with people that are also not deluded anymore, that are actually grounded and open to however life unfolds, so we can together serve God. That is my dream, actually, that I have people that are enlightened themselves around me, that we can together serve a mission to build on a new earth. So I will do everything that I have in me to guide people towards that. I don't need anyone leeching on me in a victim consciousness. No, I really want people as fast as possible to wake up and yeah, start doing the things that we came here to do for God and God only. All right. Thanks for listening. Hope it was inspiring. And probably until the next one.